is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this solved official exam exercise, we are going to explain the existence of the induced current in a square-shaped loop. Apply Lenz's law to specify the direction of the induced current. Determine the value of the magnetic field as a function of time. Determine the magnetic flux crossing the loop as a function of time. Calculate the induced electromotive force. Deduce the direction of the induced current from Faraday's law.
The aim of this exercise is to determine the direction of the induced current in a square-shaped loop by two methods. For this aim, consider a square-shaped loop ABCD of side A equal 10 cm and resistance 2 ohms, placed in a uniform magnetic field B whose magnitude varies with time. The direction of B is perpendicular to the plane of the figure as shown on the left figure. The right figure shows that during the time interval 0,4, the magnitude B of the magnetic field as a function of time. Part 1. An induced current flows in the loop during the time interval 0,4. Justify. Look at the second figure. At time 0, B is equal to 0.4 Tesla. And then B decreases to 0 at time 4 seconds. So the magnitude of the magnetic field changes. Then the magnetic flux crossing the coil also changes. Therefore, an electromotive force is induced in the coil. But since the loop forms a closed circuit, then it carries an electric current.
Let's move to part 2. Apply Lenz's law to specify the direction of the electric current in the loop. Look at the right figure. The magnitude B of the external magnetic field decreases with time during the time interval 0,4 seconds. Then, the direction of the induced magnetic field produced by the induced current must be same as that of the external magnetic field in order to oppose the decrease in the magnitude of B. This means that the direction of B induced is inwards. Now, let's apply the right-hand rule to determine the direction of the induced current. We must curl the fingers of our right hand. In this case, the thumb must point inwards. If the thumb points inwards, then the fingers of your right hand must be curled clockwise, which means that the direction of the induced current is clockwise.
Focus, please. This is important.
Part 3. Prove that the expression of the magnitude of the magnetic field during the time interval 0,4 seconds is B equal minus 0.1 T plus 0.4 in SI units. Look at the second figure. B varies linearly with time. Then B has the form of MT plus small b, where small b is constant and M is the slope of the curve. And the slope is given by delta B over delta T. To determine the slope, let's take two points from the curve. The first point having an abscess of 4 seconds and an ordinate 0 Tesla. And the second point having an ordinate 0 second and an ordinate 0.4 Tesla. So M, which is given by B2 minus B1 over T2 minus T1, is equal to 0 minus 0.4 over 4 minus 0, which is equal to minus 0.1 Tesla per second. To determine B, we have to take one point from the curve. Let's take the point having an abscess 0 and an ordinate 0.4 Tesla. Now, replace B by 0.4 and T by 0 in the expression of B. So 0.4 is equal to M times 0 plus small b. Then small b is equal to 0.4 Tesla. Therefore, B becomes minus 0.1 T plus 0.4 in SI units. Part 4. Determine as a function of time the expression of the magnetic flux crossing the loop. The magnetic flux is given by this formula, S B scalar N. But B scalar N is equal to the magnitude of B times the magnitude of N times cosine the angle between B and N. But N is a unit vector, so the magnitude of N is equal to 1. Therefore, the flux is equal to Bs cosine n b, or cosine the angle between n and b. The unit vector n is given using the positive sense. The positive sense in the figure is oriented in the clockwise sense. So, curl the finger of your right hand in the positive sense, so the thumb indicates inward, then n is directed inward, so the angle between b and n is zero. So, the flux becomes b a squared cosine zero, where a squared is equal to s. Since the loop has a square shape, then s is equal to the side times side, which is equal to a squared. Now, replace b by minus 0.1t plus 0.4, and a, which is equal to 10 centimeter, is equal to 0.1 meter, and cosine 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, the flux becomes minus 0.001t plus 0.004 in SI units.
Let's move to part 5, deduce the value of the induced electromotive force. In the previous slide, we found the expression of the magnetic flux crossing the loop. To calculate the value of the electromotive force, we use Faraday's law. Now, we must differentiate the expression of phi with respect to time. Now, the derivative of minus 0.001t with respect to time is equal to minus 0.001, and the derivative of the constant 0.004 with respect to time is equal to 0. Then this is going to be E is equal to 0.001 volts. Let's move to part 6. The induced current in the loop is given by E over R. Deduce the value and the direction of I. Let's start with the value. I is equal to E over R. E is equal to 0.001 volts and R is equal to 2 ohms. Therefore, the value of the induced current is equal to 5 times 10 to the power minus 4 amperes. Let's move to the direction. This value is positive, which means that the current is positive. Look at the positive sense. The current in the loop is in the chosen positive sense, and the chosen positive sense is clockwise. Therefore, the current is clockwise. Part 7. Compare the direction of the induced current obtained in part 6 with that obtained in part 2. In part 2, we specify the direction of the induced current by applying Lenz's law, and the direction is clockwise. And here also the direction is clockwise. Then the directions are the same.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.